Hello everybody, this is Patty with A Soul's Heartbeat, and today I am here with a new product that was sent to me, and this is how it came. It's Barely Art, and it is a new glue. And if any of you watch my channel, you know I primarily use a liquid glue and Suquan score tape. So I'm going to put my brand of liquid glue away for the next month, and I'm going to try this on all of my projects and all of my videos, and at the end of a month, which would be the first part of September, I'll give you another review and let you know what I think, because we can do a little bit here today, but until you've used it day in and day out and get a feel for it on all different kinds of things, it's hard to know what your personal opinion is going to be. But this is the Influence box that they sent me, Influencer box. Isn't that cool? And I gotta tell you, I love the packaging. This is a USA product. Comes from Arlington, Texas. It's called Barely Art. And look at here. This is a refill bottle. This is 11 ounces. This is a non-toxic glue. It dries clear and it's flexible. And as you can see, I'm taking it out for the first time. I have not done anything with this yet. So here's my little bear. And then you get a bottle. This is a 4-ounce bottle with a removable lid. You get a storage cap, I believe it's, nope, this is something else. I have to look and see. And the tips. So, and this cute little box that you know darn well I am going to repurpose that some way. Okay, so let's see what we can find out about this glue. First off, they have included a tag. It says Barely Art monthly giveaway. Tag us at Barely Arts on Instagram for your chance to win a free bundle of glue. So if you do a project with using their art, tag them and maybe you'll get something. It comes with Precision Craft Glue, and I printed this right off their website because I didn't want to forget anything. It says, what's in a tip kit? Tip kits contain everything you need to craft like a pro. Each tip is designed with special base that securely locks the tip into the cap. It only takes a second to switch to the tip you want. So let's open this up, see what we have here. Okay, this is a plastic vial, I believe. Ooh, we have a long pin for cleaning. We have a long nozzle, plastic type tip, and then we have the metal type tip in the shank, which I'm used to, and this green one, and I believe this is a plug, the storage one. Okay, so number one is this one. This is an ultra fine tip. It's made with stainless steel end and a plastic base. This tip is our most precise tip, and it can be used for anything that requires high precision. This is what I use most of the time, is a tip like this, because you don't need as much glue as you think you do. And over gluing lots of times creates puckers, or you see it on the reverse side, or it oozes out and you just have a mess. And I have found that just using these small tips on my projects, I get a much better outcome. Okay, so this is the ultra fine tip. The fine tip is an all plastic tip that's great for all crafts that require more glue but still need precision. I think I'm going to find this one really interesting, and I've never had anything like this. The tip cap is just what I said, a quick and easy way to keep your glue from drying out. And then you have a cleaning pin. If your tip gets clogged, the stainless steel can clean away the toughest of clogs. Okay, so let's see. We take the top off that came with it. It has a seal. And this is the hardest thing for me. Oh, goodness. And this is nothing for them. This is just me. I have a hard time with... Oh, it's coming. It's a coming. Okay, there we are. Now this, just looking at it like this, seems a lot more liquidy than the glue that I normally have. Now I'm going to put on my nozzle end like this, and I'm going to put this precision tip in, and you put it in, I believe, I don't know if they're, there we go, it's in already, like that. Ooh, wow, look at that, comes out with no problem. Okay, I'm going to put the pin in it for now because I want to tell you a little bit more about this. Let's clean that mess up so I don't have that gluing to something. Okay, from their website. Also, as we design our glue to stand out, it's non-toxic, safe to use. Create more, refill less. And they have these great, oh, I love these bears. Oh my goodness, I've smashed the end of him in, but once I get the glue out, I can poke it out because you know darn well, none of us crafters are going to be able to get rid of these silly little bears. It dries clear, hides the mess. Now, I don't know yet whether this will dry clear with a sheen to it, or it will dry clear so you don't really see too much. That will come in the next month as I begin to use it. It has the precision tips, which we just went through here. I think I'm going to put them right here in the cup, like that. Really, I should put them in my little thing, but, oh, here it is. Let's put this one and this one back in here, and I'm not sure what was on the top of that right now. I don't see it, so we'll look for that. Okay, it has multiple tips for more choices. It's flexible and resists cracking. It's wrinkle resistant. Now, if any of you have, like when I do my cards, and I'm putting something on the front card base and I put the glue on it and I put it down. If your paper is thin, sometimes you see those lines through it. Same way with a mini album page or in a journal. And I hate that. So we'll see how this works with it. Clump resistant, stays smooth. Now with the other glue that I've used that's similar to that, I've had no problem. I used one time, well-known name brand that is like a Modgy Podgy stuff. It was not Mod Podge, but it was like that, and I got a thick goo runner all up and down the whole shaft. You could pull it out like a long thread, and I don't want, so I'm assuming that's what they say, clump resistant, stays smooth. It's designed tough for a strong hold. Well, after a month, I'll be able to tell whether things are beginning to pop apart or not. Designed durable, long lasting. Now, here's a great thing. It thaws if it's frozen. Use it all year. That is the only thing with the other glue that I have, and I bought a huge container of it, so I wouldn't have to worry about it. But I know other crafters, that was their problem, getting a big enough supply in the winter before it became at a temperature where the other glue would freeze, and then it would be no good. So this says it thaws if it's frozen. I was going to see here what if it said anything else here. Well, let's just read this. Directions. Twist off the flat cap. Twist on the precision cap. Choose a precision tip and apply a thin line. Set time 5 minutes and full cure is 24 hours. Times can vary depending on the temperature and the humidity. Now, that's another thing. My other glue, it dries so fast sometimes that you have no maneuverability. I'll be real interested to see if I have the adhesion, but a little bit more movability. Storage. After each use, clean the tips with warm water. If buildup occurs, use the cleaning pin to clear away any blockage. Store with the green stopper or flat cap at room temperature. For best results, use thin lines to increase strength and reduce wrinkles. Use different precision tips to adjust your flow. Always clean the tips after each use. Manufactured by Barely Art in Arlington, Texas. Okay, so I have some paper bag envelopes because I made a whole bunch of cards and I needed envelopes. These are grocery bags is what I use. And I'm going to try this and we're going to set these back and see how they work. Oh, wow. Well, I can tell you it comes out like a dream. Now it will be, if it clogs very bad. You can see this is an Albertsons bag I'm using. You can use any, but it's a great way to repurpose your bags. Okay, so I'm just gonna do these and I'm gonna set them aside. I have a couple of them, so we're gonna do them so we can give it. I just have a couple things here to test, and then like I said, I'm gonna come back in a month's time and we'll do another little review on how it has worked over the time frame. But the projects that you see going forward, it is much, much thinner. I can tell you that right now from what, this isn't a milky consistency, but it is much thinner than what I've used before. Let me get a little something out here. Have a little air bubble there. But it flows. Oh my goodness. I don't think I would do well using the big tip, because for me, I'm getting a really nice line. Look at here. I'm getting a really nice line coming out with it here. Now, I contacted Barely Art the other night before I did this video, because when I went on their website, it says free shipping in the USA. I couldn't see anything that said free shipping, you have to spend $30, or free shipping, blah, 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 something that way. I couldn't find anything that said anything that way. So I sent them a text message and asked me, and they got right back to me. They've been really good about that. And they said anything right now, and I don't know how long this will be this way, but anything right now you purchase through the Barely Art website or through Amazon, because I guess they're selling on Amazon, there's free shipping. So in the US, people. So, okay, now let's make a tag. I've taken just a manila tag, but I've inked around the edges. And this one, I've inked the whole thing. Sometimes I find, and this is a distressing, sometimes I find when I have inked something, the glue doesn't want to stick to the distress ink as well. I might have to go back, getting another little air bubble, and I don't know if that's just something, I don't know. No, it's no problem. I'm just noticing it happening. So I wanted to see how this would work. So I'm going to just cover this tag, but I want to, this is going to be a little pocket, and I want to cover this with a piece of paper. And you can see it's all icky on that end. This is the paper that I've been using to, my scratch paper that has been down on my desk. Oh, now there what I did. Let's see how this comes apart. Oh, I can take it apart. Doesn't seem very sticky, but that's okay. Oh man, there we go. Well, if I had cut it straight, I guess it would have been a lot better, huh? So I'm going to move it up here and I'll just have to trim it afterwards. Let me get a little, one of my AARP cards. I have a lot of these floating around. Okay, now I gotta get a pair of scissors because I really, well, I guess I can just leave that because I know this is a little bit thicker than my tag. Now I just use my AARP card to go over this front and back. Now I want you to see, I can't see any wrinkles here, front or back. And you saw how much I put on there. So that's a pretty good thing right there. Now, this is going to be for something that I'm making. So I'm just going to run this up in the back. And as I said, I have to trim this. So don't go, wow, man, she doesn't do anything very well. Okay, so we're gonna just going to run a thin bead up the side here. And maybe in the middle, this is where it's going to go on my fold, and up the side here I'm going to take my tag and just put it in here. And now I was able to move it around just a little and fold this up. That's going to create my pocket on the back. And I got to get a baby wipe, everybody. have one out here, sorry. But I just want a baby wipe to take off any excess I have. And then let me trim this, because otherwise I can't show you, because it will drive me crazy, because it's not the way it should be. Come on. That's better. Come on. Okay. Now for some reason here, I have a little bit of excess. I see it trying to bubble out of the top, and I don't know if that's normal. I don't know what I would be doing that would be causing it to do that. So, trim this sides off. Okay. So that's, see, now I got a pocket here and I got a pocket there, and that is, oh, and I glued that one. No, I didn't. No, I don't know. I guess it just stuck. There we go. All right. Now, I wanted to do this one too, because this I have inked. You can see. Let's do it on this side. I've inked this one pretty good with my distress ink. And I'm just going to put a nice hefty amount all around here, because I'm going to glue this straight down to my tag. Okay. Now, I want to see if we, boy, it lets me move it a little bit, which is nice. Where's my thing? And I'm going to just use my credit card. Okay. Well, I don't know. I can't see any little bubbles or anything. Can you guys? And this is pretty thin paper. This is pretty thin paper. Maybe a little here, but we'll know after it dries. I don't know whether it'll probably dry it after I'm off camera. But okay, so let's go back to these and see how we are. Oh, well. Okay, I'm really reefing on this. I'm really pulling. I don't know whether you can tell or not, but I am really pulling. Well, here. How about them apples? Wow. I'm happy with that. And this was inked. Oh, yes. Really happy, Barely Art. Really happy. Okay. And then we have these that are... This one looks good. Okay, so there's my new product. I am getting it to pop up over the top, and I don't know why. I may have to send them a note and ask them. Maybe because it's just been opened and it's so full. Don't know. Now, the other thing is, say I'm all done. If I was going to be using this in an hour, I would pop my pen in it. The only thing I wish, and I don't know about you guys, is I wish, Barely Art, if you're listening, I think it would be great if you included 3 of these pins, because we all lose them and we all hunt for them. And it would sure be nice if I had some spares that were long like this and didn't rust. Okay, so now I'm all done. I want to put it away for 2 days because I'm not going to do anything. So I twist that out. Wow, that was easy. And now I take my little green one and I put it in like this and twist it. That was easy too. And nothing there. And there we are. We're all done. Ready for the next time. Well, let me get rid of my mess. You don't need to see it. So far, just on what I've done right here, and I just can't see any wrinkles in this anywhere. And it's stuck. Wow, I really like how it dries. Now, I've got a trim here, so I'm not going to do much with that. Really like this. And it isn't here because I didn't run my glue all the way, but man, that's really a tight seal on this paper bag. So, everyone, I will put the Barely Art link below. Go check them out. give them a try. I'm going to use this, like I said, exclusively when I use liquid glue for this next month. I will only use the Barely Art unless I run into some enormous problem that says, oh, I just can't do this. But from the preliminary looks here, I don't think I'm going to have any problem. So check them out and see what you think. I'm all for a new glue. I love, you know, we use a lot. If you're a crafter and you do junk journaling, if you do scrapbooking, if you do mini albums, if you do card making, anything that way, I use a lot of glue. So to have a new person in the running with a great product, I think it's just a win-win for all of us. So, Barely Art, thank you very much for supplying me with this sample kit. I will be using it this next month and we'll get back to you guys and let you all know what I think of it. And you will hear as I do my projects throughout the month what I think of the glue. I'll try to mention it each time. So have a great crafty day, everyone. Go check out the Barely Art website. And thanks a bunch. Catch y'all next time. Bye, everybody.